A very good morning. You are watching New Vision TV News around Uganda. I am Ruth Inasije, and here we look at stories making headlines across the country. We start off today's bulletin from Ankole region. The parents have been urged to use their influence as family heads to advance girl child education. The Bishop of Northwest Ankole Diocese, Amos Majezi, said with efforts from the government, non-government organizations and civil society to improve their situation, millions of girls still face deep-rooted inequalities. He was addressing stakeholders of Chibubura Girls Secondary School during the handover ceremony of its head teacher, Monica Mbabazi, who has clocked 60 years. The mandatory retirement age for civil servants, Mbabazi, who served in the position for 12 years, handed over the school administration to the new head teacher, Cecilia Amanya. Prior to her new assignment, Amanya was serving as head teacher of Nachenyi SS in Rengo District. Mbabazi had served in schools such as Zimbara High School, Bijera Secondary School, and Chibingo Girls in Shema District. Moving on to Kasese District, now district leaders are partly to blame for the poor health services in their area. Dr. Sarah Biachika, the Health Ministry's Commissioner for Planning, has said she was addressing stakeholders at a regional meeting at Springs International Hotel in Kasese Town. The meeting, supported by the Belgium Technical Corporation, was attended by resident district commissioners, LC5 chairpersons, chief administrative officers, district health officers, and representatives of various development patterns from the Renzori sub-region. Convened under the BTC-supported results financing modality, the meeting was aimed at addressing the gaps facing service delivery. Under the modality, health facilities which perform well get more funding, while those performing poorly are funded accordingly. Biachika challenges stakeholders to supervise health workers and facilities more closely for effective service delivery. Now, news coming in from Arua District. Thugs on Saturday night broke into a Bongit Catholic Church. Alechit Parish Priest George William Ojulo said they took 29 plastic seats, including some of the unidentified property. Ojulo said this paralyzed the Sunday service as Christians remained puzzled. He said the incident comes barely a week after another church, Ayago Catholic Church, was also broken into, and plastic chairs, altar clothes, offertory baskets, and Bibles were taken. The police have since launched investigations to establish individuals behind the church robberies. And finally, from Soreti District, now property owners in Soreti Town have asked Uganda National Roads Authority officials to clarify on compensation for people to be affected by the road rehabilitation under the Northeastern Road Corridor Asset Management Program. Charles John Magnot, the Grievance Committee Chairperson for Eastern Division, said tenants have left houses for fear of demolition. Abdul Latif, a landlord, asked UNRA officials to be considerate when choosing a contractor to avoid shoddy work. And Stephen Obore, the UNRA officials team leader, asked the landlords to address their grievances to the concerned committees. On compensation, Calvin Ochen, a surveyor from UNRA, said they are working transparently and the affected people would be compensated. Paul O'Meara, the mayor of Soroti Municipality, asked the stakeholders to avoid politicizing the project. And that's all I had for you. Thank you for watching. Be sure to catch more news updates and other programs here on New Vision TV by visiting our website www.newvision.co.ug. I am Ruth Nasije.